JJ, thank you. So that's me. In fact, there's nothing major and all that. It just happens. Things happen in your life and you do things. And, you know, the credit is just you're there. That's all. So tonight we're going to talk about epilepsy and how it affects the family. A lot of it is valid for all chronic health conditions, really. It's not only for epilepsy, but anything chronic will give you these sort of problems. Before we start, I would like to thank the Center for Epilepsy and Seizure Education in BC for inviting me to talk. It's always a pleasure to renew and to see people again. And particularly Julie, who has worked a lot on that. I would like also to thank Dr. Professor Mitten, who is a man from Charlottetown in Virginia, North Virginia somewhere, and who has a very good talk. If you have the opportunity to see it on YouTube or whatever, it's called CSEE, Seizure and Epilepsy Education. And it touches on these topics, right? It's a two-day workshop that he gives on his exam. I'd like to thank the College of British Columbia, the College of Physicians and Surgeons of British Columbia, who helped me find articles on this topic, because the literature is very scanty. There's very little that has been done in searching on the impact of chronic health impairment and the impact of epilepsy on the other members of the family. And I would particularly thank my patients and their families, who over the years have taught me a lot, and in particular, I hope they have taught me to be a better physician and to understand a little bit better on these issues, because you go through training and you come out of medical school and in fact you realize very quickly that you don't understand anything. So let's start. I was asked specifically not to talk about epileptic issues or seizures and how you treat and what you do and everything, but just a couple of numbers. The incidence of epilepsy is 10%. Incidence means the chances of any one of us to have a seizure in our life. In other words, in a family of 10 people, chances are one will have a seizure during the lifespan. And that's different from the prevalence of epilepsy, which is the number of people who have currently an epileptic problem, who have seizures or are treated at this very moment in time. And that's 1% of the population. These are two concepts that are slightly different, and that we need to make better. And in a family like these ones, it does create a fair amount of difficulties. Chronic health impairment do bring stress in the family, and I want this tonight, we are not very numerous, we are not many people, to be an exchange. So you can please go ahead and tell about your own experience, because it's important. And that's very important to know how you feel and what has been your experiences on that. But it does bring stress, and what is valid for epilepsy is also valid if you have Parkinson, if you have diabetes, to a certain extent. Here is an example of a family with some members, the one with the red dots having seizures. So, we can understand that Evelyn, for example, might have issues different than Eric or Charlie or others. But every one of them have concern relating to the fact that they have a husband, a daughter, a brother with epilepsy, or a child with epilepsy. And all these create pathology or problem, psychological problem in the family at different levels. Now, this is a picture. You would wonder what it is, but you can see it very closely. And some others, they would see that. Some others see that. Some others see that. Some others see this. And tonight, exceptionally, for the first time in Abbott's world, we will all see the full animal, the part of the elephant that everybody sees from his inside. There is the beast itself. That's the elephant. Now, each one of us, as caregiver, we have different aspects that we see of epilepsy. The doctor sees the treatment and seizure control. The mother, she sees her child who is suffering and would like to take it for her and not for her child. The other children at school, who might find that it is disturbing and disrupting their learning. EEG tech sees the epilepsy from a different aspect of little ways. The neurologist will see you once a year, will see different things. So all these people have their own